right, which talks about the joining association with network by CS members in practice. Right, so let us look into this new arrival into the syllabus, which is regarding the joining. Right, joining over there, why I am taking it after 2, 3, 5, 6? Because 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? Because you see over here, in terms of clause 2, 3, 5, 6. Now, do you know 2, 3, 5, 6? Clause 2, not to share, 3, not to accept, 5, canvassing, and 6, soliciting. Right, it is not permissible for members to, in practice, to join network other than the networks registered with the institute. Right, so you have to get your, now network registration with ICAI is mandatory. Right, so Deloitte India, just as an example, I'm telling you, right, it has some say 13 offices in India. Example, I don't know the number, I'm just telling you as an example. Right, they have an office in Pune, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Delhi, right, Mumbai. So many places they would be having their offices. Okay, now each, if it's a partnership firm, each firm it cannot exceed more than 20 partners. Okay, so say example, I'm telling you, Pune, Mumbai could be one partnership firm. And of Deloitte. Then after that, say Delhi, one firm, right, where 20 partners. Say all India, Deloitte has some 400 partners. Okay, now different entities they would have created for the same. But finally, whichever Deloitte it is under the same brand name. It is under the common brand name. So whether I look at Pune, Mumbai, or I look at Hyderabad, or Chennai, or Bangalore, or any other place where Deloitte is there. Okay, it is under a common network. Right, I'm talking about a network of Deloitte across India. Right, now what does it say? You cannot create a, you cannot have a network unless and until the network is registered with ICAI. Right, what are the forms? I'll come, let me finish the entire discussion. Then if you have any question, we can talk about it. Right, what are the forms in which you can have a network? It says one, the network could be formed as a mutual entity. Second, it could be formed as a partnership. Or you can have a network in the form of an LLP. Or you can have a network in the form of a company. Right? One firm, it can join only one network. Right? One proprietor, one sole proprietor, one partnership firm, you can join only one network. And common partners, even you can join only one network. Right? Common partners, how many networks you can join? Only one network. It's like a synergy benefit, no? You're coming together as a group. Okay, now Deloitte, though they have a common brand name, but like say you four friends are practicing, all having your individual practice, but you want to mutually help each other. Right, so can you form a network together? Yes, but it says that network has to be registered with ICAI, mandatory. Okay, now when you look at the name of a CA firm, what is used after the name of the firm? And associates or and company. You know, ABC and associates, C and company, D and company. You see those, no? Names of CA firm. What does it say? ABC and associates or ABC and company. Now, to distinguish a firm LLP from a network, it says when you're creating a network, you have to use the word and affiliates after their name. Right? So, when you say it's a network, then it will be Deloitte and affiliates. Right? It could be say PWC and affiliates. It could be ABC and affiliates LLP. Right? Because it could be form of LLP. Or it could be ABC and affiliates when it is on the form of a partnership firm. Or it could be ABC and company. Right? ABC company affiliates. So now to distinguish that this is not a firm, this is not a LLP of the firm, it is a network. What you need to use the name in the name of the network? The word and affiliates. What do you have to use in the name of the network? The word and affiliates. So I talked to you about two things. One, the different forms of network, and second, the name of the network. Right. What are the four forms of the network? If you come to the C or right, the C point over there. It can be constituted as a mutual entity, partnership firm, LLP, or a company. And what did I say? Network firm can consist of the proprietor or the partnership. A firm is allowed to join only one network and common partner again only one network. Did we see that? Right? Form of network. What are the forms? Mutual entity, partnership, LLP, or a company. Then the name of the network, to distinguish it from a firm, they have to use the word and affiliates instead of and company or and associates. What they have to use after the name of the network? And affiliates. So if network is a mutual entity or a partnership firm, AB and affiliates. If it's an LLP, AB affiliates company. And if it's a company, then AB affiliates private limited or the whatever, private limited or limited. Are you understanding that? Right, so maybe just for a quick understanding of this. Right, so we are not looking into CARO 2020 right now, but if you look at the end of this document, what does it say? About SR Bartley Boy and Affiliates, that's the name of ENY in India. And so it says SR Bartley Boy and Affiliates, network of firm includes. So SRB Bartley Boy and Affiliates is what? It's a network. And which all firms are registered under that network? SRB Bartley Boy and Company LLP, SRB Bartley Boy and Associates LLP, SRBC and Company LLP, SRBC and Associates LLP, and SV Ghatalia and Associates LLP. So these are all which are registered under that one network. Right? These are all the firms, these are all the LLPs, you know, or the individuals which are under one particular network. So what is the name of the network? SR Bartley Boy and Affiliates. And what are the network members? Which are the firms in that network? These are the firms. And the LLP, LLP, then Associates LLP, and again the Ghatalia and Associates, that is again the LLP. Are you understanding? Right, so obviously Big Fours, it is more in a professional and a well-organized manner. Okay, but if I show you this one more. Okay, now that is the ENY, na? It is obviously one network. But these are now some different people who've come together. AGM and Affiliates, your GST friend. Okay, AGM and Affiliates. Okay, and then we are always there to support you. Yes, AGM and Affiliates. Huh, AGM and Affiliates is a duly approved network. So it is not yet registered with ICI. It is yet to be registered. It says it's a duly approved network. So first you need to apply to ICAI with the name of a network, right? Then within 30 days of the receipt of your form, ICAI will approve the name of your network. Like LLP registration also, no? You apply for the name of the LLP. And once the approval for the name of the network is received, then within 3 months, the network has to be registered with ICAI. MCQ, they will ask this question, right? Within first, you need to apply to the ICAI for the name of the network. Once the ICI receives the form for the name of the network, within 30 days they will reply, okay, this name is available, you can create a network with this name. And then once the name is approved, within how much time you have to register your network with ICAI? Within 3 months from the date of approval of the name of the network. Are you understanding that? Can I enter into a network with company CA firms in India and also outside India? Yes, you can also be affiliated with some CA firm outside India also. Like Deloitte India, can it be associated with Deloitte UK or US? Yes. Right, so even the network could be with entities which are registered outside India. Right, so what did I say? First, you need to make an application to ICAI. And ICAI within not later than 30 days from the date of receipt of the form will approve or reject the name of the network. Right, and once the approval of the name, after the name of the network is approved, the institute will reserve the name for a period of 3 months, and the network has to be registered with ICI within a period of 3 months. Registration of network with ICI is mandatory, compulsory. Now any network you create, what does it say? Registration, whether in India or outside India, with ICAI is mandatory. And if you enter into some network outside India, what does it say? Within 30 days from entering into the networking agreement, you have to give the details to ICAI. You have to file a declaration with ICAI. So, you know, Deloitte India entered into association with Deloitte US, whatever. Within 30 days of entering into such an agreement, what does it say? You have to file the declaration with ICAI. And networks within India, what does it say? First, you need to apply to ICAI for the name. Once the name is approved, then within 3 months, right, the network has to be registered with ICAI. Any change in the constitution of network, say any member joined or any network firm, they left the network, then within 30 days, again, the change is to be communicated to ICAI. Are you understanding that? Okay, and now let us look into the definition of a network. Pay attention. Right, most important part of the discussion, R raised to 50. What is a network? It is such a wonderful definition they have created. It says a network is a larger structure. What is a network? it is a larger structure. And first golden rule, you know, for you to say that we are a network is that it should be aimed at cooperation. You know, it should be aimed at cooperation. And huh, what is the first golden rule to say that today hum to network hai? You know, when you are saying you are a network, when the you aim is at cooperation. And in addition to that, and it also clearly aims at, they've used the word clearly. It also clearly aims at, are you with me? What is first golden rule? Aims at, aimed at cooperation. And then also and clearly aims at profit or cost sharing. It clearly aims at the profit or the cost sharing. Or what else it could be sharing? Common management, ownership or control. Common management, ownership or control. Or common quality control, policies and procedures. Are you with me? Common quality control, policies and procedures. Or you could be sharing a common business strategy. Right? What is the fourth thing you could be sharing? Common business strategy. Right? Or you could be sharing a common use of a common brand name. And a Deloitte. Use of a common brand name. Or the significant share of the professional resources. Like, you know, Pune office requires staff, so they are sent from Kolkata office. Hyderabad office requires staff, so they are sent from Delhi office. Right? So, significant share of the professional resources. What is first golden rule? Aimed at cooperation. And apart from cooperation, what are the other 6 points? Huh? Clearly aims at the profit or the cost sharing. Are you understanding? Or common management, ownership or control, or common quality control, policies and procedures, or the common business strategy, or the use of a common brand name, or the significant share of the professional resources. This is the definition of a network. What is the definition? A larger structure that is aimed at cooperation, and that is clearly aims at profit or cost sharing, or common management, ownership or control, or the common QCPP, quality control policies and procedures, or the common business strategy, or the common use of a common brand name, or the use of significant share of the professional resources. Are you understanding that? Right? That's the definition of a network. Everybody, are you with me? Right, so if you look at the definition of network, that is what the definition says. A larger structure that is aimed at cooperation, and in addition to that, clearly aimed at profit or cost sharing, or shares common ownership, management or control, or common QCPP, or business strategy, brand name, or a significant part of the professional resources. Right, look over here now. Right, what is the first golden rule for it to be a network? It should be aimed at cooperation, right? It should be aimed at cooperation. So if you look at the next point in your books, okay, in all the points, do you find this word aimed at cooperation? Right? Does every point say aimed at cooperation? Right? Does each and every point say it should be aimed at the cooperation? Right. And in addition to aiming at the cooperation, what is the other thing it should aim at? It says any one combination. And aimed at cooperation and is clearly aimed at the profit or the cost sharing. So that's a combination of one and two. Second one, aimed at the cooperation and with common ownership, control or management. So that's a combination of 1, 3. Are you understanding? Aimed at cooperation and common quality control policies and procedures. So that's a combination of 1, 4. Then aimed at cooperation and common business strategy, 1, 5. Aimed at cooperation and use of a common brand name, 1 and 6. And aimed at cooperation and sharing of significant part of professional resources, 1 and 7. So first, you know, when I also read, I said, what is this now? And a concept of network, such a big. But then when I read it, I understood. You know, one thing compulsory, aimed at cooperation, and in addition to that, you combine with any other. It could be a combination, you understanding now? It could be a combination of 1, 2, or 1-3 or 1-4 or 1-5 or 1-6 or 1-7. It says you are a network. Are you understanding? Okay. You are a practicing CA, I am a practicing CA. Okay, just separate practicing CAs. I am referring some work to you, you are referring some work to me. Are we a network? Like we said right now in 611 ka exception, applying, requesting, inviting, securing professional work from another CA in practice. So, you know, applying, requesting, inviting, securing work from another CA in practice. Are we a network? Are we a network? No. It says just referring of work from one person to another. It says that does not necessarily create a network. Right? They've clearly given it over there. Right? Does not, the sharing of immaterial cause does not in itself create a network. That is one they have told over there. Right? Then what does it say? The sharing of the cost limited to such particular work. Then the referring of work just by one to another. It says that will also not constitute. A larger structure may be aimed at only facilitating the referral of work. Point number one. Which in itself does not meet the criteria necessary to constitute a network. So just because one CA is referring to work to another CA doesn't mean we are network. Because that comes under the exception to 611 only, na? Okay, applying, requesting, inviting, securing. It says that is not a network. What is a network? Aimed at cooperation. Wo to golden rule hai. And after that, what else does it aim at? Clearly aims at profit or cost sharing. Then what does it say? Just sharing immaterial cost is again not a network. Sharing of cost related to development of audit methodology, manual or training courses again will not constitute a network. An association with unrelated jointly to provide a service or to develop a product does not in itself create a network. So little bit sharing here and there, it says it does not create a network. Then aimed at cooperation and common ownership control management, aimed at cooperation and common QCPP, aimed at cooperation and common business strategy. And an entity is not deemed to be a network merely because it cooperates with another entity. Right? So just cooperation, no. What does it say? They should have a common business strategy. Then use of a common brand name, right? That obviously means it is a network, right? Just, you're not a part of the network, but the reference you're making on stationary promotional material, it says it's not a network. Huh? Even though a firm does not belong to a network and does not use a common brand name, it may give an appearance that it belongs to a network if it makes reference to stationary or promotional material. So you're not part of the Deloitte network, but on your promotional material, stationary, you're writing Deloitte. So what wrong impression may be created that you are a part of the Deloitte network. So if care is not taken, if how the firm describes as membership, a perception may be created that the firm belongs to a network. So obviously only who can put it on the stationery or promotional material who are registered under that one particular network. Okay. Then sharing significant part of professional resources. They've explained over there what are the examples of the professional resources. You're sharing the partners and staff. You're sharing common billing system, technical department, audit methodology. These big fours, they have an audit software, no? Right? Or the training courses and facilities. So that is significant part of the professional resources when you are sharing. That was the seventh point, no? Right, significant share of the professional resources, significant part of share of the professional resources. Form of network already discussed, name of network discussed, registration of network discussed, ethical compliance. Okay, now, so how many of these ENY entities have they talked of over there? Right, ENY, some 4 or 5 entities over there. Now see this SR Bartley Boy and Company, the first out of this list. Okay, say the first out of this list, they are doing the statutory audit of Jio Limited. Okay, now can the other four provide 144 services to Jio Limited? Out of the firm, you know, which firm? Four firms they have over here, na, LLP. The first one is doing the stat audit of Jio. Can the other three do 144 services for Jio? No, now the disqualification is not applicable to the firm, it is applicable to the entire network. Are you understanding? So it says one statutory auditor. Now the other network members, they cannot accept, do the internal audit or bookkeeping or any professional assignment for which are prohibited for stat audit firm. So now the disqualification is not for the firm. Now the disqualification is for the network. Then ceiling on non-audit fees is again now applicable to the entire network. Like, you know, it should not exceed, it should not be more than the stat audit fees. any consultancy services which you provide to the client, MCOS fee should not exceed the stat audit fee. So if your stat audit fees are 50 lakh, maximum how much MCOS you can provide to the client? 50 lakhs. So now, all the other put together, what is the ceiling on non-audit fee? 50 lakh only. There is a notification of ICAI which says for a client for which you are doing statutory audit, maximum how much other services you can provide, keeping in mind 144, blacklist though anyway is not allowed. Maximum how much service you can provide, not more than stat audit fees. Example, stat audit fees 50 lakhs. So other services, maximum how much you can provide? 50 lakhs. So now all that put together, that ENY card network, it cannot provide fees of more, services of more than 50 lakhs. So ceiling on not audit fee is applicable to the entire network now. Right. Then rotation of firm, that rotation rules of company as that is now again applicable to the entire network. So cannot happen that 10 years they appointed Batley Boy and company, then 10 years they appoint and associate. It goes without saying, na, okay, now it is applicable to the entire network. The network may advertise the network to the extent permitted by the advertisement guideline. And network has to comply with the ethical standards. Right. So when you create a company, you have memorandum articles of a company. When you create a trust, you have the trust deed. When you create a partnership firm, you have the partnership deed. Now when you create a network, there has to be bylaws of your network. Right, there have to be the internal rules and regulations, there have to be the bylaws of your network. And what does it say? What all should be included in the bylaws of the network? The managing committee, the administration of the network. Then obviously now network also has to run, na? So all the participant firms, they have to pay some fee. Right, so the managing committee, the administration, the membership fee of the network, dispute settlement, because when you start as a network, it is all goody good. But after few days, if one member of the network gets more work, network firm, the other gets disturbed and then dispute. And so dispute settlement, we are talking about the bylaws, are you understanding? Right, dispute settlement, then training material, newsletter, software development, maintenance of database, library, technical director, methodology of drawing resources from each member firm. I told you, now Hyderabad office, can they get people from Pune office? Yes, drawing of resources from other firm. Right, compensation to the member firms and the peer review of the member firms. Right, so that is the rules and the bylaws of the network. But what I find most important over there is the definition of the network. What is the definition? It's a larger structure aimed at cooperation and clearly aims at profit or cost sharing or common ownership management or control or the common QCPP or the common business strategy or use of a common brand name or the significant part of sharing of the professional resources. So what could be the combination? 1-2, 1-3, 1-4, 1-5, 1-6 or 1-7. One is constant. It has to aim at cooperation.